hustle to death and they blunder. Overnight they become millionaire from the start.
Good night, comrades. Tonight I'm very pleased to be in All Saints East and St. Luke's. I must apologize for the late start, but I'd like you to understand that the Antigua Labour Party is committed to the rescue of Antigua and Barbuda. In a little while, I will show you some very important slides to prove that the UPP administration set out to execute the most massive rip-off of the people of Antigua and Barbuda. You will remember when this issue was raised in Parliament and Baldwin Spencer attempted to defend it. What Baldwin Spencer did not know was the Labour Party was totally committed to uncovering the truth about the rip-off that his government has executed on the people of Antigua and Barbuda. But I want you to place a few things in your mind before we go to the film. Just within the last week, the Antigua Labour Party had to file a case in court against Baldwin Spencer and his administration because they have changed the law to steal the election in Antigua and Barbuda. I want you to keep your eyes on what is going to happen in the High Court. I want to also remind you that this very week is the 8th anniversary of the UPP. And on the 8th anniversary, the people of Antigua and Barbuda are going through the most difficult time in its history. Nobody in our says East and St. Luke can stand up and say truthfully that their lives have been improved. As I stand here tonight, hospital care has become a distant reality to the people of Antigua and Barbuda. If you do not have money, you cannot afford proper medical care in Antigua and Barbuda. As I stand here tonight, our educational system, our schools are in the worst shape they have ever been. And so tonight, I'm going to use my time to show you on top of all the ills that are taking place. Baldwin Spencer has now established himself as a defender of the greatest lie that has ever been perpetrated on the people of Antigua and Barbuda. You recall when they had the press conference? There was a Chinaman at the press conference, and he told the people of Antigua and Barbuda that the engines were new. Even though they were rusted, they're still new. And the rust was because they were in the elements. They were getting wind off of the ocean, and so the salty air rusted the plant. Well, look at that film, look at that screen. Those plants came to Antigua well wrapped in plastic, well protected from the elements. So that was the first line. It's an awful thing when the UPP politicians lie to you, but when a man fly from all the way to China and come and lie to you, you know something is very wrong in Antigua and Barbuda. Look at the screen. Those are the six engines, all wrapped in plastic. So this thing about salty air, corrosion because they were in the elements, is a big fat lie. We are going to now move quickly to show you the conditions of the plants. As you see, you all are here, you see the plastic on the plant. Look at that. Well protected from the elements. So why are the plants rusted? Well, let's go through the film. First thing I want to show you, all those of you from All Saints East coming here tonight, look on the plate right there. Any new plant would not have a rusted plate that shows the manufacture and the model of the plant. Look at the edges, and I'm telling you that this plant, this picture, was taken within 3 months of the plants being installed up at Crabs, within 3 months after they took out the plastic. You look at this photo here, and your eyes will not easily pick this up, but in the middle white spot, you see there, that is a missing bolt, a broken bolt without the nut. You tell me, how could a brand new plant come to Antigua and come with a broken bolt without a nut? And when you look underneath in the crevice of the plant, you see all the rust, the accumulation of dirt and all that on that plant. And they are telling us that it's a new plant. They're bringing a team of Chinese men who are supposed to arrive in Antigua and Barbuda sometime this week to tell you the same fat lie. This is the top of the engine, and you look there and you see a tag on the engine. Why part of the tag is gone? That looks to me like an engine that is in operation long time, and over time part of the tag comes off. Keep on going. Here you see the open engine for yourself. Look at all the oil leaks. Look underneath and the crevice. You see the oil leaking. And by the way, I want to give you a breaking story tonight. Breaking story tonight. I have now have the documentation. The documentation when the APUA workers went to China and what they wrote in their report. And I'm telling you, when I let this out in this country, you all are going to be so mad you might pluck Paul Spence out of his office. Because he lied to you. I have the documentation now. Yes, I have it. I have them. And we had them. We had them. We had them. Look at this plant. With all the leaking oil in Antigua in that plant. And when the matter was raised with Baldwin Spencer, this man said to the people of Antigua and Barbuda, why are you expecting a plant? Wine? Wine? You think I have to love it? In other words, it is fine. It is okay for Baldwin Spencer for the Chinese to send an oil plant in this country that leak oil all over the place. All over. Keep on going. Come with us. We don't have a lot of time. And what you see, look at that. Stay right there. Look at the portion of rust that is coming through the paint. Look at that. That plant was somewhere, maybe in the Pacific, doing some work. Somewhere in the Pacific. That can't be a new plant. We are not stupid. Is it the Baldwin Spencer is saying to the people of Antigua and Barbuda, you don't have the common sense to look at something and make a decision. Huh? Look at all the oil leaks there. Look at the floor. Look at the floor. And I'm telling you, these pictures were taken in December. These pictures were taken in December. And the plant was open in September. What are these oil doing on the floor? They bring leaky pipe. And when the pressure gets into the pipe then bursts and oil all over the floor. Let's keep going. Now, look at that side, look at the side of that engine. Now, that is exactly how that came from China. Thousands of miles away. It is a shame. It is a shame that the UPP government made Antigua and Barbuda dumping ground for old iron. It's a shame. If you're going to spend $47 million, my goodness, it should be at least new. Even if it doesn't work, it should be new. And look at that. Look at that. You all are seeing for yourselves. We are not here to mislead you. And one of the things they did, you know, when we started showing the pictures, they said, oh, they doctored the pictures. That is what they said. But you see, when the people see these pictures, and there was a particular engine with the wrong number, and we showed that, go back to that plate commander, we showed the picture with the wrong engine number, and the Chinese man at the press conference said to the people of Antigua and Barbuda, we apologize for the wrong number. He said it, we apologize. Well, that confirmed to everybody, the only way he could have seen that picture, that number, was on the pictures we took. The pictures that Carrie Marina took when they went up there. Now look at that. I mean, when I saw this, I rest my case. Look at that plane. That can't be new. Look at the bottom. You see the corrosion. You can see now they try to spruce up the plant by putting on another coat of paint. And they're so sloppy, the paint, they didn't even paint the engine itself. They paint the paint too. At least they should get a better painter, man. They should come to us as East and St. Luke's and get a painter. Let's keep on going, come with us. Now, you have to look carefully. You see in between there? Where do you think those things are? No, they put the push cart in between the engine. And I notice that they love purple cloth. Not a purple. You see there? That is cloth. When I went up there in December, when I asked Baldwin Spencer if I could go and see, I saw the cloth myself. Comrade Ross was there. Comrade Robin Yearwood was there. We all saw it. Now look at that. Look at all the leaks taking place. You know, this is not only criminal, this is sinful. This is not only a crime, this is a sin. Nobody should do any country this. Nowhere in the world has anybody tried this. Keep on going, comrades. Keep on going. Yes. We want to get to some more graphic ones. I want to hear some more speakers tonight. Look at all that nonsense here. And we know by now, oh my goodness. You all seen that? Go back to that, comrades. These people have no shame. And you know something? After we went up there with the Carrie Marina took the pictures, the minister of tourism said on Observer Radio that APUA is at fault, because if they knew that we were going up there, they should have spruced up the engine. That is the minister. You know what he means by sprucing up? They should have done something to deceive the people of Antigua and Barbuda. Can you imagine a politician has the gall to go on radio and say, deceive the people? We keep on going. The more I look at these pictures, the more angry I get. $47 million and counting. We now know that is about $52.5 million. And when the Prime Minister was asked how much in Parliament, after he tried to insult me, he couldn't even call the numbers. 299, 999, 999. Oh my God. Oh my goodness. If you're going to, you know, if you're going to be fresh, you better be good. If you're going to be forward and insulting, you better be good. And if Baldwin Spencer want to insult people, you better learn to count. Now look at that. I believe this picture should be taken, put on a billboard about 100 by 100, and stick up somewhere in St. John's. This is the biggest shame. Look at this. They use cloth, tire pipe, Wash that pipe. Look at the condition. Look at the condition of this plant. I am saying to you that never before in the history has Antigua and Barbuda been dealt this heavy blow. And I want to say to you that notwithstanding all the things they're doing to shut us up, the message should be clear to Baldwin. We are not going to stop until we cover the entire Antigua and Barbuda and carry the message and expose the deception, the lie, the thievery, and the ripoff of Antiguans and Barbudans. We are not going to stop. Come on, come with us. Look at this. You want more?
Give me more.
And by the way, I have documentation that that proves that the government knew of the leaks. They had the documents where they write the report saying that the engine is leaking even from the piston. How could a piston leak of a new engine? You ever get a new car? If you buy a new car from Hadid, and when you drive home, you see oil on the needle, what you do? No man, you not come back. You just say that bad in me, what you expect? I need you, you are wine. Oh, Lord of mercy. You know, this is so serious, really. Because let me tell you, come on, let's go back to that picture there. The one with the purple. Let me say this. The serious part of this exercise is that this engine that cost $47 million was a US dollars. Was on the market for $18 million. For $18 million. That is what this engine was on the market for. And the company that produced the engines were formed within 2 months after the government signed the loan agreement. The company never made an engine in its life. And as a matter of fact, it was not even the company that made the engine. That company had to go to another company to make the engine. That is what they have done to the people of Antigua and Barbuda. And what they expect us to do is to remain silent so that you, every time you get a light bill, every single time you get a light bill, there is a portion of your light bill that you have to pay for that nonsense. If Antiguans and Barbuda get angry enough, everybody should take a vacation from paying their light bills. Take a vacation until they fix this matter here. This is wrong. And we are committed in the Antigua Labour Party to go to the length and breadth of this country. Don't care what they try to do, we are not going to stop. And I want to say to you, the people of all says, East and St. Luke's, you are part of the solution. You have a person, I can't even say young man. You have an individual in your constituency here. You voted for. And we don't come into you. We come into Jennings telling the people of Jennings that he's going to run down the St. Mary's God. I never seen this before. How could a person, I can't say man, how could a person elected by this constituency after 3 years turning back on the people and say, look, I want to run over there. Now let me tell you something, we can't wait for him. Let me tell you this, the people of Jennings and Ebenezer know Chester Hughes very well. But let me tell you something. The serious part of this is that he has a problem. And he's not going to bring the problem to Jennings and Ebenezer.
Why?
So you all have to decide how you're handling up here.
Let me tell you, have you hand him up here? He's already come. He knows what's waiting for him. But I want to say you here tonight. I want you all to keep your eyes on the ball. This is no ordinary politics in Antigua and Barbuda today. And politics is supposed to be about people. Sometimes in Antigua and Barbuda, it appears as though this politics is a big show. Ministers of government becoming rich overnight, driving around while their constituents are suffering. This is not what politics is supposed to be about. How many of these ministers are serious about the young people in the country? How many of them care about the health care you get when you go to Halberton? When we go to Parliament and we raise issues about the well-being of Antiguans and Barbudans, believe it or not, they sit back and they laugh. When you say to them, their parents who don't have money to give their children to go to school, they say, "Chups," and they laugh. They are in a fantasy world. They're not in Antigua and Barbuda. While this country is sinking. And I want to wrap up tonight with a final observation to show you how far this government will go. We have the national accounts that are supposed to go to Parliament. We have the national accounts for 2004 to 2011 that's supposed to go to Parliament. The Minister of Finance stood up in Parliament and said to the people of Antigua and Barbuda, we are going to produce 2005, 2006, and then we are going to leapfrog over 2007, 8, and 9, and bring 2010. So everybody sat back and wonder what the minister up to. So me check it out. Anytime you see them make a move, check them out. You know what I found out? 2007, 2008, 2009. Those are the years when this government spent $10 million a mile a road in Antigua and Barbuda. That period is the same period when they spent $54 million on fence like this and bathroom for $600,000. That's the period. That same period includes the expenditure for something called romantic rhythm. So here it is. The law said, the Constitution of Antigua and Barbuda said, that those accounts must come to Parliament. And because Baldwin Spencer, Howard Lovell and his gang want to hide up the thieving that took place, the minister say he not bring them to Parliament. But let me tell you, he must.
Have to.
Because if he doesn't, we are going to court. This court is going to be very busy. If he doesn't, we take legal action.
Thank you.
Because let me tell you, when they bring the accounts to Parliament, it gives the leader of the opposition in Parliament the opportunity to call anybody to account for the money they spend. And that is what they are afraid of. So we're going to call all the people who spend money romantic with him, even the ministers. Even the ministers. So if the one, the little junior minister that spent $54 million for their getaway, here come before the chairman of the accounts committee. And that is where we are in Antigua and Barbuda. When they are not stealing blatantly, they're breaking the laws of Antigua and Barbuda. I want to say thank you for the opportunity to present this to you tonight. And I want to assure you that we will continue to fight the fight for labor and fight the fight for Antigua and Barbuda. Good night.